Okay. If I'm not mistaken, we are live right now. Yep. Okay. Let's see. See if this is working. It is working. Unfortunately, the game is in 16 by 9, which there's nothing I can do about. This is a 4 by 3 game, but yeah, can't do anything about that. Well, it looks crisp. Hey, Sean. Just checking out my SNES here, seeing if I can get it to work. Is there any game audio? Because I don't think there is. Can you hear any game audio? Okay. Well, whatever. This is. Oh, fuck. Why did I do that? This is more of a test than anything, anyway. The game audio is not working for some reason. But I got that little adapter that takes an RCA signal, so red, white, and yellow, and it converts it to HDMI, so I can use it with my capture card. But it creates input lag. So I had to take an old RCA cable, just RCA to RCA cable, and splice it, and use the red and white cables as a splitter. So I had so that partway down the SNES controller, it split off, and then I could plug one of those into my TV and one of those into the converter, so that I mean I could there was no input lag, so that I can actually, well, speed run, hopefully. Although I'm so bad at speed running this game, it's so rusty at it too. But whatever. Oh, and YouTube defaults the video quality to like 240p. Turn it up to 480p. And the reason it's only 480, not like 720 and 1080, is because this game is in 480, so there's no point in having the video quality up that high. Am I coming through fine? Oh, jeez. Well, that was dumb. I was trying to fix my mic, and here I am standing there like an idiot while the space station's blowing up. God damn it. God. Getting annihilated by steam. The rust is real. 40 seconds, it's fucking awful. So if you see me like mashing the shoulder button, so if Samus is looking like diagonally up and down like really fast repeatedly, it's not just because I'm trigger happy. In this game, every time you hit the shoulder button while running with Samus, it pushes her forward one pixel. So like mashing the shoulder buttons is moving her head each one pixel each time you press the button, which doesn't really seem like a whole lot, but it adds up over the course of the whole speed run to like 4 extra seconds. But if you do it on a slope, like if you're on a downward slope and you do it a bunch of times, you'll actually push Samus forward off of the slope, so you don't want to do that because that's bad, obviously. is like my least favorite room in the whole game. I hate speedrunning this room. It's so fucking awful. Oh my god. So, have either of you ever seen a Super Metroid speedrun? You watch me one time at my place. Well, if that's it, then man, thank God, because if you've watched AGDQ or something like that of this game, oh man, oh my God, you'll realize how terrible I am at this. But that's okay. I accept the fact that I'm terrible at speedrunning this game. Not only am I terrible at it, I'm rusty and terrible at it because I haven't played it in so long. It's awesome. Loving it. Oh my god. Can't believe I just fell down there. That was stupid. Oh my god. Thank you, game. Loving ya right now. Hey, I haven't taken any damage though, that's good. So I can actually maybe one round of this boss. Oh man, your internet's being shit. That sucks because this game is. I mean, it's a speedrun, it's really precise, so that sucks. Well, I accidentally shot him one extra time. If I shot him the correct amount of times, then his head wouldn't have blown off, and then he would have just died right away, but whatever. Oh my god, did I just actually fail that? What the fuck? Oh my, what the fuck? Why can I not do this? I like never fuck up on that trick. So bad. That was really dumb. Turns around and gets hit. Hey, Spencer, welcome to the stream. Got that little adapter thing I needed, so now I can actually play other games. So this is a bit of a test right now. The game is in 16 by 9, which kind of sucks because this game is obviously not supposed to be 16 by 9, but we make do. Oh my god. Wasted a super. You is here. I'm good at this game. Better be fucking good at this game. It's my favorite game. Ah, damn it. Fucked up on that damage boost. Spencer, you jinxed me. You said I'm good at this game, now I'm gonna play like shit. I'm actually gonna break from the actual speed run, and I'm gonna save the game. And I'm gonna see if I can practice this Kraid quick kill because I need to. Oh yeah, this game is actually really hard. On Speedruns Live, this game has the highest quit rate. It has a higher than 50% quit rate for like professional speedrunning. So like it's like in the 60s or something. So 60% of people that try to speedrun this game quit because it's too hard. And like every year they do a four-way Super Metroid race for AGDQ. And last year, like this year, everybody died except for one person in the run, which is crazy because I mean it's Super Metroid. They've been playing this game for how long? I forgot to save. I just went back to save and I realized I didn't save. But that's okay, because I can still try. I probably won't succeed at this, but I can try. Oh, I don't have enough super missiles anyway. I had three, I needed four. Nice. Playing like shit, loving it. You're playing Skyrim? Skyrim is a good game. Thanks for jumping there, Samus. Seamus. I'm watching what, Connor? I'm not watching AGDQ right now. I'm speedrunning. Can't watch AGDQ while playing this game. Don't be making each other sad. Aw, Matthew, you're joining the party? Welcome to the stream. Oh my god. What, Sean? What's off? Fuck. My terrible, terrible run right now, because this is going horrible. Oh my god. When you don't jump as high as you should, because you suck at the game. Oh my god. How do I fuck up on that? I'm just supposed to go straight. I clenched the controller too hard and for some reason pressed the up button, got out of Morph Ball. Oh my god. Can I just. Yeah. Thanks, game. Can I jump, please? Please? God. I'm so bad. Shut up! Shut up, Spencer. Says I'm good at this game and then proceeds to say I'm bad. You're bad, Spencer. He's right, though. I am doing pretty bad. Yeah, I may have said it myself, but you're supposed to support me. It's funny. Like, I'm always like, "Oh, I'm doing so bad at this game." But then if I got any of you to try to just like proficiently wall jump, I bet you like it would take all of you a long ass time to do. 'Cause it's so like, well, you've seen me wall jump as though it's nothing in this stream. It doesn't even look like it's a trick really, but it's actually really hard to do. Oh my god, punk ass platform, getting him away. You can wall jump in Smash. Yeah, but Super Metroid's really hard to wall jump in. Like, it's not just. Really? Doesn't jump, just runs off the end of the platform? It's not just, jump at the ledge, then press back and jump at the same time. It's kind of complicated. You have to jump, like, it has to be a spin jump. You have to spin jump towards a wall. And then, when you press, like, hold the arrow away from the wall for. That was really dumb. For a few frames, Samus will be in, like, another position where her feet are on the wall and she's, like, facing away from it. If at that point you press the jump button, she will kick off of it. So, like. You probably see if you pay attention when I wall jump off a wall to the left, so she'll be facing you. You'll notice that there's like an animation where she's face she where her feet are on the wall and she's like facing away from it. God damn it. Oh my god. This run is terrible. You're confused. I'll actually demonstrate it because this isn't really a run. I'm not actually running because I'm not even recording my time right now. But I'll show you what I mean. There's actually if you tap very slightly away from the wall and you fall along the wall, then you can see the animation for longer. But you can see Spencer watch when I turn away from the wall, you see that animation where she's like her feet are on the wall. I'm doing it like multiple times as I go up and down. You have to jump towards the wall, and when you tap away, she does that frame of animation. It's really short, but when she does that, you have to press jump at the same time. like that. And Super Metroid has like jumps that you can control, so the longer you hold the button, the higher you go, and the shorter you can do tiny hops. So like you can do wall jumping on the spot, and then you can go up like far. So in some spots there might be an enemy above you and you're wall jumping and you don't want to get hit, so you'll wall jump slow and then you'll go up far and stuff. Wall jumping is pretty important. It's hard to do. Well, like if you go to the beginning of the near the beginning of the video, you'll see me wall jumping up a long ass, like really tall shaft room of the game. Like that's ridiculously hard to do. But once you get it down, it's like it kind of becomes second nature wall jumping. But just to go to show how hard it is, my friend Alex from Vancouver, this is his favorite game of all time, and he has troubles wall jumping, like he can barely do it. Aw, Spencer, you gotta go. Am I boring you? Am I boring? This trick is really precise, and I hate it. You gotta shoot out that block and wall jump up really fast because it respawns. Oh, damn it. And then you got to see it respawn. And then you gotta jump through, but you have to wall jump off of right there to get through, and it's really hard to do that. Nice. Right into the plant. Those are called damage boosts. Basically, what you do is right when you get hit, right when you get damaged by something, if you press jump and the opposite direction you're facing, at the exact moment you get hit, you'll like do a backflip in that direction. So you can use it to your advantage by like in this room, running, jumping, and then quickly turning around to do a damage boost. So quickly turning around like back forward while holding jump to do a damage boost. It's kind of tricky, but you can really yeah, I just damage boost off of its spike that it shot out there. You can damage boost off of really anything as long as it can hurt you. Would I do another run after this? If you guys want me to, if you want me to do another run after this, I can. Why do you guys find this interesting? Okay. There's a lot to show in this game. I think that might be part of it, but I'm just gonna save here because I'm gonna practice a trick that I need to learn. It's my favorite trick in the whole game. It's really cool. It's called Ocean Fly. You might have seen it before because I've probably talked about it. Yeah, speedrunning is option. It's really hard, and it really wears on you, but it's really awesome. This game is fucking ridiculously hard to speedrun. Murder. Speed booster is awesome. Boom. Get out of here. I actually didn't get ice beam. For some reason, I haven't been doing that. Okay, so this trick, I'll explain it. It's really complicated. So a shine spark is where you get speed booster and then you crouch during your speed booster while you're blue to store the charge, and you'll start flashing white like that. And then you can use it to just like rocket upward or diagonally or straight forward or whatever, horizontally or whatever. I'll actually show you in this room back here because it's the best room to see it in because it's really big. It basically you fly in any given direction until you hit something. So store the charge. and you can fly in any direction until you hit something. And it drains your health while you do it, but it's obviously very fast. So you can do it horizontally too, like that. And so what we want to do for this trick, I'm going to restore all my health because I drained a lot of it. What we want to do for this trick is shine spark through two rooms of the game, because we don't actually, we need the grapple beam to get through, Samus's grab, the in Super Smash Bros. We don't have that item to swing across these chasms here, and we don't have the gravity suit to travel freely in water, so we can't wall jump underwater because these next couple rooms are filled with water. So I'll show you this room over here. So what we got to do, because this water slows us down dramatically, as you can see, we can't really walk in it very well, and we can't wall jump. If I try to wall jump, it just pushes me out straight. I don't actually gain altitude. So I need to horizontally shine spark across this room, but I also, when I come through this room, I need to shoot, jump, and do a shine spark across the room and follow my bullet with the shine spark. So the bullet opens the door in front of me as I, and then I go through it as I open the door. But a normal bullet is really slow, so I need to use a super missile, which is faster, which is way faster than a regular bullet. I'll just show you. That's a regular bullet. That's a super missile. So you can see it's a lot faster. And then another aspect of this trick is when Samus is running for Speed Booster, to get Speed Booster, you think, oh, it expects you to hold run down for a set amount of time, and then after a certain amount of time, the Speed Booster kicks in. But actually, that's not true. It only checks on certain frames of Samus's run animation. So if you don't hold down the run button, this is what it looks like without running, and then this is with running, so it's faster. If you don't hold down the run button and you just tap the run button on those frames of Samus's animation, you can get the speed boost way sooner. So you can see if I just try to do it normally, you can see I start to glow blue right at the end of the runway here. But if I do a, if I tap cleverly, I can, well, if I do it properly, I can get it there. Like, I can get it on top of this. And then I can jump over here with my super missiles equipped, and then I need to somersault into the next room, shoot a super missile, and then do a horizontal shine spark. But the issue with that is after somersaulting and shooting, I break out of my spin, and it's kind of like in Smash Bros. After doing your recovery, you can't shine spark, you just fall straight down. So while I'm in the air, I need to angle up to break out of that and then do the horizontal shine spark. So I need to like jump, shoot, angle up, and then horizontal shine spark all in one motion, and it's frame perfect. So it's really hard to do. So let's see if I get it here. Nope, I didn't even jump. That was stupid. But it's a really cool looking trick once you get it, and it's really, really like satisfying once you do it as well. Did I even open the door? Yes, I did. Okay. Fuck. See, I did a horizontal shine spark, or a vertical shine spark there. Is this now melee? Too much button mashing? Well, it's not button mashing. It's all like very articulated and precise. It's not button mashing, but it is really difficult. Like, Super Metroid requires a really unique. Fuck, I did it again. I don't know why. You do a vertical shine spark if you don't press the angle up button. Pressing the angle button lets you move horizontally again after shooting. So yeah, it's weird. Well, I did it, but I did it too soon. See, if the missile, I have to shoot the missile at, like, it's frame perfect because you have to shoot the missile when you're like about here, like in the middle of this, between the missile and the door, because if the missile is too far away, then you'll open the door too late and you'll bump into the door and end your shine spark during the run animation. And if you're too early, then the missile will go too far off screen and it won't actually open up the door. So you need to get it within about, yeah, it's like frame, it's almost frame perfect. Oh, I didn't get it there. See, the super missile has to be between the edge of the right edge of the screen and the left and the edge of the missile thing. Oh, I did get it. Just. But this is what it looks like. And you get across this whole screen, that both of those whole screens, which otherwise would take a long ass time to get through there, because you can't, like, you need grapple beam or something like that. You can do it with wall jumps and clever jumping, but it takes forever. The only thing now is because we shine sparked for so long, I'm low on health and I'm about to fight the hardest boss in this entire game, Fantoon. So I gotta be really careful here. Generally, at this point of the game, I have more than three energy tanks. I'd probably have around five or six if you're doing a casual run. But because this is a speed run, I only have three. Actually, at this point in the game, you're only supposed to have two, but I grab three because I can. I like to have the extra health. Whoa, fast pattern. So this guy dishes out some massive damage. His balls of fire here do about 20 damage to I don't know exactly how much. It's like 30 damage or something like that each, and they're obviously flying everywhere. Especially when he opens his eye, they just fly out everywhere and they're really hard to dodge. But and he has a lot of health too. And he's really random. Like sometimes it'll take him a long time to open up his eye after he respawns. And sometimes it takes not that long at all. Like, oh, he's being a bitch. I'm actually, oh, he's being really nice to me today. He's not doing any of his like hard attacks or slow patterns or anything like that. He's almost dead already, actually. But this boss is probably the most dangerous in the game. Let's see if I can. Oh boy. Yeah, see, I got hit by two of them and I'm already like really low on health. See, you really can't let your guard down at all during this fight. I'm almost dead. If I get hit like two more times, I'm dead. Holy shit, how is this guy not dead yet? This is ridiculous. He is so bright. And he's only dropping missiles. Holy shit. He's not dropping health. Okay. Okay, he's dead. Just barely made that fight. Now, after that fight, it kind of sucks because this is the most dangerous place in the entire game. The enemies in here dish out a lot of damage. It's small here, but it's dangerous. Hell, there's an enemy in this place that takes away an entire energy tank with one hit. So that's 100 energy per hit. And that's just tremendous. It's ridiculous. And there's these little sparks here. If you touch any of these sparks, they do like 15 points of damage, which is really high to begin with, but because they're also everywhere, I use them to damage boost. Oh, that was more. That was like 20 points. But and then these freaking molecule weird things, they do a lot of damage. They also take a lot of shots to kill. I just use three missiles. But yeah. God damn it. There we go. Yeah, you just clip through the wall there. I don't know why.
If you jump on a certain frame there, you can just clip right through the wall. This is one of those rooms where you have to kill every enemy in the room for the doors to unlock. Funny, every room in this game has a name, like for speedrunning, and some of them are pretty clever. There's a room here where you morph ball and you go like the Chozo statues, you turn into a morph ball and go in its hands, and it's in a really long room, this room here with the spikes. So some people this room is actually nicknamed Bowling in Super Metroid because it looks like he's gonna go bowling. It's kind of funny. And of course, those blocks up there on the ceiling are grapple beam blocks, so you can swing like lasso swing off of those with the grapple beam, but I don't have the grapple beam, so I just have to run through the spikes. And it looks like this guy's just taking us back where we came, but he's actually got a secret down here. It's called Noclip. Now we have the gravity suit. Now we're purple and we take less damage from enemies and we can move freely in water. Literally one of the biggest blessings ever. Okay. This room over here, right here, this is called the Hell Way for obvious reasons. Very dangerous room. And this room over here is called the Red Tower. I'd say this is probably one of the hardest rooms in the game to go through. It's really difficult to successfully, like, do a perfect travel through this room. Oh my gosh. I have really hard time damage boosting off of those guys. I don't know why. Whoops. I was reading the chat and I just. Oh, I don't have any. Oh, shit. I don't have any power bombs anyway. That's bad. I'm supposed to have power bombs right now. Well, let's go in here and see if I can get some. Oh yeah, and the gravity suit also protects us from lava damage. That's nice. I don't really need to freeze those guys. I just realized that I don't take damage from the lava. Please just give me a power bomb. Holy crap. I didn't realize I didn't have one. There's a spot in this in like before here that if I didn't have a power bomb, there's an enemy that always guarantees you power bombs. But I'm long past that now, and I didn't realize that I was out. Oh my gosh, Connor, telling racist jokes to your family. My family wouldn't care. We joke about stuff like that all the time because we know we're not actually serious about it. We're just joking around. Oh my gosh. This run is pretty much ruined. I'm not taking it serious anyway. I was practicing a trick earlier, but yep. This guy here. This guy, yeah, see, he always gives you a power bomb. But I was dumb and I wasn't paying attention because I didn't care. Once you know it's a bad run, you just don't care anymore. Oh, fuck you. This is Meridia. The most confusing place in the game, unless you know the path off by heart because you speedrun. Nice. Oh my god, I'm not used to having a frozen fish there. Damn. Fucking hell, why am I doing so shit? Okay. There we go. Oh, I need power bombs, right? This is another spot where if you don't have power bombs, you need to get them. There we go. Nice. Totally what I wanted to happen. This is rough. Schemes are nice to me. I don't know why that's happening. I've never encountered this issue before. That's what's supposed to happen there. Just not the 18th time. Well. Awesome. God, there's a music cue there, but I can't hear any audio, so I have no music cues. Oh wow, I'm low on health. He is almost a dead Sneaky. God damn it, I hate this boss so much. Gotta shoot him so many times. And if you don't hit him in the head, it doesn't count. The shot doesn't count. You have to shoot him in the head. That's his only weak spot. Just die. Oh my God. Just dodging my bullets. Yeah, punk. Seems like you have a butthurt family. Oh my God, get me out of this sand. Well, never had that issue before. I'm encountering a lot of new issues in this game that I've never had before. Damn. Damn, I'm out of missiles here. Oh boy. Out of missiles for a boss fight. I just need to kill that turret. Whoa. Fuck off. I don't know why he was spitting goo for so long. Usually he doesn't spit it out for that long. That's weird. He usually stops spitting goo. Yeah, like that. When he gets close to you, he stops spitting goo. Nice. Shot right through that goo, but it caught me anyway. Yeah, I think I'm gonna die. There's nothing I can do. Like, I don't have anything, and I can't dodge him here. Like, I have no health, and I can't dodge him. Yeah, there's nothing I can do there. Notice how he didn't drop any health at all. Like, for the entire fight, he only dropped missiles until the very end when I was doomed. He dropped only health, just to fucking be a douchebag. God damn it. I never died. That's like an easy boss, too. I just wasn't prepared for the fight. And I was trying to do a different way, because there's a way where if you probably saw me running back and forth in the room, there's a different way of killing him where if you. Did I open this door on accident? Yes, I did. If you. You can manage to do like. Because the amount of times you do for the short tap, like what I'm trying to do here to get the speed booster early. The amount of times that you can tap up to like 4 times or 5 times, and the more times you tap, the better your chance of, or the shorter distance you need to get the shine spark. But the downfall with that is it's harder to pull off because it's frame perfect. You have to do a frame perfect trick simultaneously like 5 times, which is retarded. And you need to do at least a 3 tap, and I think I can only do a 2 tap. But you have to do at least a 3 tap for that boss. Can I just, yeah, thank you. Well, I could restart and actually try to do a speed run. Maybe. Or actually, I don't really want to play this game anymore. I could play like something else. Something else. Well, okay. First, I'm gonna actually go get a drink. I'll just put it on this so that there's something on the screen, but I am gonna go get a drink. I will be right back because I am thirsty. Wow, okay, I'm back. What the fuck is going on here? I leave for like how long and you guys are already like Spencer, I quote, "Dick is fully hard with pants off." Quality. Quality. That's all I gotta say. Okay, so let's toss some games here. What do you want me to play? Street Fighter 2 Turbo, Final Fantasy 6, Sim City, which, oh fuck, that's boring as shit. X-Men Mutant Apocalypse, Arcana, which is like a dungeon crawler RPG, and su or Super Mario World. Those are your list of games, other than Super Metroid. So, the options are in, waiting for a vote poll. It's up to you guys. Other than Super Metroid, because I kind of don't want to play that right now. Wears me out, man. I'll probably just do a speedrun of Super Metroid every night, along with any other game. I'll just do take t stick it to one a night. So, not playing Balloons Tower Defense. Can I repeat that? Oh my gosh. Okay. Okay, guys, seriously, actually, what do you want me to play? Super Mario World, Arcana, which is the dungeon crawler RPG thing, X-Men Mutant Apocalypse, which is a beat 'em up, Sim City, which is a slow game, Final Fantasy VI, or Street Fighter II Turbo. That's the list of games. Take your pick. I'll reread through them again. Street Fighter 2 Turbo, Final Fantasy VI, Sim City, X-Men Mutant Apocalypse, the beat 'em up game, Arcana, the dungeon crawler RPG, or Super Mario World. Skyrim. I'm shut up. Super Mario World, that's one vote. Arcana from Connor. Oh, we need a tiebreaker. Super Mario World or Arcana? Movies. Final Fantasy VI, god damn it. Okay, Sheldon, you're the tiebreaker. Who, what do you want me to play? Sheldon, come on, I can't play Skyrim. Don't pick Skyrim. It has to be one of the games I listed. Street Fighter. Steert Fighter. Okay, Sheldon, you're still the tiebreaker. Spencer, you're retarded. Oh my god. Street Fighter is cool. It's just Steert Fighter is not a game I have. I don't think I've ever heard of that game. Steert Fighter. Okay, it seems like you want me to play Arcana. And it's spelt, well, I'll type it in the chat how it's spelt. Like that. I'm really, really upset about this. I'm gonna see if I can get the sound working first because this game has an amazing soundtrack, but you can't hear it because there's no sound. But it has an awesome soundtrack. It's great. So I'm gonna see if I can get the sound working. So we'll see what I can do. I'm gonna turn on the light and then I gotta put the headset down. I'll be right back. Okay, so I just restarted the stream. Tell me if I have audio. Because I should have audio now. Not game audio. Of course, there's no game audio because it doesn't fucking work. But you should be able to hear my voice again. Oh my God, Matthew, be quiet. Matthew, no, I can't hear you. I'm actually gonna head back because, oh yeah, because Saurians appear and they kill me. Oh fuck, and yeah, they dodge your attacks like a fucking bitch. And they do a fuck ton of damage. Yeah. Now you're wrecked. Nice. I remember when I first met you, Alex. You were like so innocent. Well, I mean, even like in the last little year. Wait, what? Hashtag what the fuck is. Is there his Super Metroid? Where is Super Metroid? I already did like a semi speed run of it. You just missed it. You just missed out, man. No, but like Alex is 2 years younger than us. So he was like legit, like full innocence. Like child innocence. Like he didn't even know what how babies were made. Oh yeah, Rook's attacked twice in a row. Oh yeah, you hate this game, don't you, Alex? Without the music, it's not as good, actually. I should probably stop playing this game because there's not any good music. How the fuck do we get. Okay. Gotta get the fuck out of here first. This place is massive. Oh, come on, slimes. What rooks? What is this gay ass checks? Checks? Chess? That would be a rook. Rooks is actually a name, in case you didn't know. You fucking nut. What do you want me to play then, Alex? Shaolin. Child innocent. No longer. Yeah. I told him how to actually masturbate, now he's not a child anymore. Super Metroid, MGS2, AM2R. Okay. A link to the past. I don't have a link to the past here, it's at my dad's house. Fucking loser. Oh boy. Oh man, I know just what I'm Gonna play. I'm gonna play SimCity. Because Alex loves it when I play that game for 3 hours on a live stream. I'm just gonna play SimCity all night. SimCity, you guys are gonna love it. I'm gonna play it tomorrow and the day after. I'm just kidding. Fuck that. I'd kill myself. I couldn't play SimCity for that long. I'll play a little bit s narrow. Maybe not. I was gonna. Fuck. Should I try to do. I'm gonna try to reverse boss order Super Metroid. I've never done it before. I don't know how to do it. Is it fixed? I'm sorry, guys. What was happening? What was happening? Havari messed up. Nice grammar, Spence. What happened? Pants are off again. Okay, well. What happened? What was happening? Static as fuck? What? That's fucked up. That shit's fucked up. I don't know what the fuck that's all about. I can Germar. Of course you can. Of course you can, Spencer. I didn't bump it. And bumping the mic wouldn't cause it to go static as fuck. I can't bump it. It's on my face and I have two hands on a controller. Okay, so I'm not gonna do like an actual speedrun route for this because I don't know how. The plug-in. Well, the plug-in is across the room. Was that 3, 4, 5, 6? Okay. I wasn't even counting those platforms. The plug-in is like across the room. This cord is like 5 meters long. And it's like across the room. So I don't know how I could have bumped it. And I that wouldn't have been the issue anyway because I didn't unplug it and replug it back in. I just restarted the stream and it fixed itself. So I think it's Recenter, the streaming software. The cancer software. So I'm gonna try to do reverse boss order, and I'm gonna collect a lot of items early game. Reverse boss order is scary, man. I gotta fight Ridley first. Like, literally the hardest. Well, yeah. I gotta go fight Ridley. How do you do that? How do you go and kill Ridley with no. What? I might have to look that up because I don't know how the fuck I'm supposed to make it through Lower Norfair and kill the hardest boss in the game with no suits, so I'm taking heat damage the whole time. And I'm being attacked by a boss. And he'll do quadruple the regular damage to me because I, fuck off. Because I don't have Varia suit or gravity suit. This is that wall jump room I was talking about. Fuck off. Oh, I didn't. Yeah, I'm just wing it. I just realized I'm gonna have to go all the way back down here. You get good and very hard all over. Well, I'm gonna try. I wonder if there's a way to get gravity suit early. Because if I can get gravity suit without fighting any of the bosses, wrong way, then that would be fucking awesome. Forgot, now that I leave, there's a shit ton of fucking enemies here. Oh, you got a bomb jump for this. I don't have bombs. Fuck, there's no point other than to get this missile. Because I don't think you can wall jump over there, it's too far away. Yeah. It's too far away. You can't reach that block, so. Yeah, you got a bomb jump up there, but I don't have bombs, so. Or ice beam, but I don't have either of those. That's okay, though, because there's a shortcut back to that area. Is there a shortcut to Lower Norfair? Dumb. I don't like this. I hate going up and down this room. Well, going down it's fun because it's just a free fall. But going up it, fuck. Carpal tunneling, man. Oh, Spencer has spoken. Apparently, everybody has to take off their pants in order for me to succeed. So, you heard the man. Take them off. Oh, yeah, and reverse boss order is only for major bosses. So, like, I can go fight this mini boss right now. That's nothing against me. Because I, well, I mean, I have to. It's Morph Ball Bombs. You can't even get past this part of the game without him. But, even Samus. But, yes, because there's major bosses in the game and there's mini bosses. Mini bosses you can actually skip entirely. We do skip one in an actual speedrun. But, what's it called? That was awesome. Totally paying attention. Love it when he does this attack. But yeah, because you only have to defeat the five major bosses of the game. Fuck off, dude. Don't do this shit. Nobody likes it. Is the audio fixed? One second. Did that fix it? Really not liking this whole audio fuck up thing. Really not liking this program. So shitty. But hey, it's that's all you got. Gotta make do with what I got. It's not fixed. Fuck. Okay. Is it fixed? Yeah, it is fixed, you fucking liar. It is fixed. Fucking Spencer lying to me, saying the audio is not fixed, even though it is. Fucking lying ginger. I'm gonna hang you. I'm gonna cut your head off and put your ginger head on a platter. Yeah, I'll fight you. I'll fucking win. Stronger than you. Whoops. Oh, fuck. When you're button mashing and you accidentally go up the ladder. Or up the elevator. Ladder. What, man? Well, come on, man. DDD dildo. What? What is? What is DDD dildo? DDD versus DDD. Lr versus lr. All right, get this. This is an item room where you get a reserve tank with a secret item room behind it where there's a missile, and then get this. A secret missile behind the secret missile. What the fuck is that? That sounds dumb, Spencer. That sounds really dumb. Why would I want to do that? Fine then, Samus versus Samus. Connor's like, holy shit, I can't handle that itemception. Ouch, that burns, man. What about Alex? You don't like Alex as a friend? I mean, he is your ex, but rip Alex. She doesn't deny it. You not hear what I said, Shallon? You were like, Spencer, the only ginger I like as a friend or whatever, and I was like, wow, what about Alex? And then I was like, I know you guys are exes, but he's your ex, but you guys are still friends, I thought. And then and then he's like, rip Alex. I mean, some would argue he's not a ginger, but I don't know. I think he's a fucking ginge. He's got ginge in him. Look, I made a ladder. Cool. This game hates me. How about that? It hates me. That we have some shit, we can go get some items up here. Did I fix it? Did I fix it? I restarted the stream. Okay, don't fuck with me. Is it fixed or is it not fixed? Okay. So yeah, I just have to restart the stream and then it fixes itself. kind of want to go down here yet. Fuck that. There's a missile we can get down there and maybe that energy tank. But I suck ass at bomb jumping because you don't need it to speedrun, so... I mean, I can do it. It's just it would probably take me a little bit, and I don't want to waste time, so... Fuck that. I shouldn't have even come up here yet. Once I figured out a route for this, like my own little route that's safe and I know I won't die doing it, I'll actually try to do this fast, maybe. Once I know what items to get and the route to take and stuff. But until then, I'm gonna blow up this motherfucker. Wait, I can go get this. This was the first item I got once I learned how to wall jump. That missile pack there. Once I learned how to wall jump, I'm like, this is a good place to learn it. Check out that secret. This game is full of them. That's the only pipe like that in this game that you can go in. I'm actually getting pretty close to death here. I should probably be careful. Not dying to the bosses, just dying to the regular enemies. Because I'm careless. Ooh, that mic bump though. Ooh, this will make things a little easier. Whoops. Fuck off, spin jump, you stupid cunt lady. Ah, I forgot about that. A gun that you'll never see in a speed run because nobody uses it because you don't need it to beat the game. But it is cool. It makes you shoot three bullets that do quite a bit of damage and are spread out. Okay. Okay. Better have fucking fixed it. I also changed I, because I haven't been unplugging it, so now I actually unplugged it, changed the port that it's plugged into and everything. Okay, I'm actually gonna save here. How much do I have in my reserve tank? Only 40. I'll see if I can fill up this reserve tank a little bit, and then see if I can do a heat run, a hell run to get the, what's it called? To get the ice beam. I don't think there's that much area in the ice beam area. That's yeah. Okay. Now I gotta haul ass like I've never hauled ass before. Oh, heat damage, holy shit. Holy shit. Oh my god, this is insane. That's two rooms, and that's an energy tank, almost two energy tanks. That's retarded. Holy fuck, I don't know if I'm gonna make this actually. Dude, holy fuck. Just made it. Fuck. Yeah, that is a lot of damage, and that was fast too. If I was any slower, I would have died. I don't know how the fuck I'm supposed to go and fight Ridley like that. Like, imagine that, but actually going through all of Norfair and then going and fighting Ridley like that. I don't know how I'm supposed to do it. Obviously, I'm gonna have more energy tanks, but still, that was two rooms. That was two small rooms. Like, what the fuck? But I did it. I got the ice beam, which is pretty important. Make my life a lot easier. when you're supposed to have Ice Beam, actually, when you come here, instead of doing that crazy shot thing, you're supposed to just freeze these enemies and jump your way up. That's what you're supposed to do, but you know. Okay, I'm kind of checking out a video, like a Super Metroid speed or reverse boss order video here to kind of see, because I have no fucking idea how I'm supposed to do this. There's got to be like a way to get one of the suits early or something. Although I think in the actual speed runs, they get another, like they get three energy tanks and then they actually run all the way to speed booster. Oh no, he oh my god, with those two energy tanks that I have, he runs all the way to speed booster and gets speed booster. Well, I can try it. I can go get a couple more energy tanks and see if I can do it. Cause that room with all the bubbles, that room's actually not superheated. Trying to find my way through a reverse boss order. There's no easy way out of this. I'm just gonna see if I can try to find as much energy as possible. As much energy tanks and reserve tanks and stuff. Like, try to get as many as I can. Although I don't even 100% this game, so I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do that, to get a whole bunch of them. You're so dumb. You probably don't even know how to get power bombs without fighting a single boss. Oh, I don't know. Right, okay. You can't do that, okay. Oh boy, this is gonna be fun. Damn it, oh fuck. I'm so bad at this. Fuck. I did this once before, I think. There's no way to wall jump up there, I don't think. Fuck, there might be. I think that might be like a pixel perfect wall jump. That's ridiculous, though. There's gotta be a way. Oh, man. If only I could do it from jump. If only I knew how to do that. But I'm bad. Why can't I do this? You're leaving, Spencer? Fuck, this is retarded. What if I take high jump boots off? Can I DI away from the wall fast enough? Oh my god, I can barely jump. Holy shit. No, it's even more impossible. I fucking did it. Holy shit. Took long enough, but I did it. All right. Okay. That was so difficult. Wall jumping this game or more or bomb jumping is fucking retarded. Oh my god, that does so much damage. All right, there's another energy tank. Fuck. He grabbed me. Oh my god. Please don't kill me here. I don't want to have to go through this room again. See, extremely early gravity suit. I just want to see if there's a way to get. To get gravity suit, like, really, really early. Yeah, I know there's no way to get gravity suit early because you need to kill Fantoon, and I can't kill him until I kill Ridley first, so there's no way. Why don't I wave dash? Why don't you die in a fire? Alright, I think after I get this energy tank, I'm gonna go to Norfair and then save. And then next tomorrow, I'm gonna try to I'm gonna end it there, and then tomorrow I'm gonna try to tomorrow I'm gonna try to get the speed booster and stuff. Like just rush it and try to get it early, like as a hell run. There's two missiles up here, I think, which I don't really need. God, giant side hoppers are like the most intimidating enemies in the game. I swear to God, they're so freaky. Well, I suppose this isn't Metroid Prime. I suppose I should try to keep my energy because save points don't restore your health in this game. So, probably shouldn't be so careless. Whoops, sorry about that. Mic bump. Right, well, that's the end of this. I am off to bed. Thank you for watching. That's the end of this stream.